We back.
You just want to start. Do you want to sync right away? Okay.
I mean, we can. Don't matter to me.
Can you just say a few words?
Hello.
Perfect. All right. Now we sync.
Sure.
All right. Ready?
3, 2, 1.
I see spikes. I got amazing. It. And I see a red light. Amazing.
Okay. All right, everybody. Hello.
What have we gotten ourselves into today?
Welcome back to another of your favorite podcast episodes.
Yes.
The Study Break.
Yes.
Today we have a very special guest, Grace Holly, aka Sparky, aka Sparky Girl. All the way from Sparktown.
Or Sparkly Queen. I think you put that in my phone like the first week of school or something.
I'm really sorry for that.
All the way from Sparktown USA, also known as Raleigh, North Carolina.
Hell yeah, brother.
Alumni of UNC Chapel Hill.
Roll heels.
Go heels.
For context, I think it was in Zaina's podcast. She said, could be worse.
Yeah.
Shout out Sparky.
She said, could be worse. Shout out Sparky.
This is Sparky.
So now we have the living legend Sparky in our
in
our studio for right today.
Happy to be here.
It's kind of crazy.
Also, I made a oopsie.
Yeah.
So a couple episodes ago on our words of wisdom, daily advice, I said, he who falls asleep with itchy butt wakes up with stinky finger.
Yeah.
But
understandable.
Obviously. I have to correct that statement. He who falls asleep with itchy butt wakes up with enterobius vermicularis.
And that's
which is
a fact.
A worm.
What kind of worm?
It's a pinworm.
It's a pinworm.
That lives in your intestines. And when you go to sleepy time, it makes its way out
your booty hole.
I was gonna say something more
more scientific.
No, I was gonna say it makes its way towards the end of your gut.
Yeah.
And then it crawls out, and that's why it causes itching. So.
Oh, and you forgot the part where it embeds itself in your butt, in your butt cheeks.
Yes.
It just embeds itself, and then you start itching.
Yes.
And you forgot the scotch tape test.
I really want to forget the scotch tape test.
I swear if my kid has worms.
Isn't the scotch tape test just like getting waxed?
Ooh, no, because you keep it on all. Yeah, that's a hot take. You keep it on all night long.
No, you don't.
Yeah, you do.
No, you don't.
Were you listening in class?
Yeah, you put it on there and you rip it off like a wax.
No. You have to, because the worms are very active at night.
Yeah.
So you leave it on all night, the tape on all night.
Oh, no way.
Mm. Were y'all not paying attention?
I didn't go to class.
I didn't go to class.
Shout out the professor.
My guy.
My guy.
Anyways, that's enough talk about butt stuff and worms.
I feel like there's never enough talk about butt stuff and worms. At least in med school.
Hey, yeah, okay, because
let me relax.
Because 2 hours of it wasn't enough.
It's wild.
Yeah. Well, anyway.
Sparky, do you care if we call you Grace or Sparky, or would you prefer Sparky?
Sparky's good.
That's all right, I'm Sparky.
If you say Grace, I might not answer.
Oh, brother.
That's actually
Sparky,
facts.
Welcome to the podcast.
Thank you.
Thanks
for being here.
We're all in our get-ups today.
We are dressed. Call me Ranch, because I be dressing.
Grace texted me.
Oh, my God.
Or sorry, Sparky texted me.
Who's Grace?
Earlier today. We were supposed to meet at 7. It's 7. Well, it's 7:55 now. But you got here at 7:30.
I did.
And
I
you
was
were
on
like,
time.
You know, I could dress up. It'll take me an extra 30 minutes. Or I can just wear, like, athleisure and come at 7. I said, let's do it, because you said you're gonna wear your hot pink jacket. I was like,
my hot pink
what
jacket.
Else would Sparky wear on the podcast?
Very Sparky outfit for sure.
Anyways
so just another update, right? So we just finished another block, which means we actually get a regular Saturday and Sunday off like a normal human being. However,
oh,
we are going to start another block on Monday.
Yes.
And I think that this is going to be a game changer for a lot of people.
You think so?
Yeah, because I feel like a lot of people haven't taken Endo Repro or have seen it before. And it can get very complicated very fast. Like, I took an endocrinology physio in undergrad.
Mm-hmm.
Loved it. My professor, incredible.
Sick as
But for people that haven't taken like an endocrine AKA or a repro.
Sparky.
It's going to be tough.
Thank
but
you.
It's doable.
Sparky has light that will guide us through the darkness.
I am going to come up with, I literally just memorize everything, which is so horrible. They say don't do that, but
I mean, if it gets you a good score on the test.
Here I am. And I will make the most crazy, the craziest mnemonics. And
what is your, what is, what mnemonic are you the most proud of? And if it's too non-PG, we'll bleep it. But what's your most proud mnemonic?
That's a good one. That's a good one. Dude, I don't even know. I can't even. Well, what was it? What was the worm that was something and it was like filiform and
strongy bone,
strongyloides.
Yes. And so I, in order to know the difference between the filiform and the
rabidiform.
Yeah, I can't say that word. And I said, but filiform is the infectious stage. So I said, fill is infectious. And that was a crowd pleaser.
I had one for memorizing the. Oh my God, Misu.
Oh brother.
I had one for memorizing the co-stimulatory receptors on T cells.
Okay.
For the cytotoxic T cells, they're CD8 positive.
Uh-huh.
Because eights are toxic.
All right.
Okay.
And I had one for crypto.
And fours are helpers.
Yeah.
And also drunk bitches always find home.
I think that's my favorite one. That's my favorite one that I've ever come up with.
That was an M2P.
That was an M2P. That was way back in the day where you're trying to figure out the order of transcription factors.
Mm-hmm.
General transcription factors.
Yeah. So it's DBAFH.
DBAFH.
Drunk bitches always find home.
Yeah.
I respect it. That's a good one.
And that shit was tattooed on the inside of my eyelids every night.
I don't even think they asked about it, did they?
No, they didn't. Yeah. Well,
there was a question on it, which pissed me the fuck off. Anyway,
that shit was tattooed on the inside of my eyelids for months.
Yeah.
And they never asked about it.
Unfortunately,
they do that a lot.
That's facts. I had one on crypto when I was so ready for it. I was so ready. I don't know the full name of it, but it was crypto, and it's the swimming pool one.
Mm-hmm,
and I was like, you got pools of crypto money. So that's what I thought. And then you had the diagnostic stage was the thick one.
Uh-huh.
And so I said, diagnosed with a thick ass. Shout out to Danielle, queen. And that's what I think of when I think of that.
Wow. And they never asked about it. That happens to a lot of things. You'll spend like an hour figuring out everything and then you'll just never get asked.
They're like, this is so important. You should know this. And then they never test on it. And you're like, okay, thank you.
I did want to get to this as soon as we could because you mentioned to me that you had a segment that you wanted to do on your episode.
On my episode, I had two segments.
Two segments. All right, so let's move into the first one.
Okay. Sparky's hot takes.
Sparky's hot takes. I love hot takes.
I don't know if you're ready, honestly.
I think we just get into it. You said one of them.
I said one of them at Super Bowl party that I'll say it. I don't think the movie Ratatouille is good. I don't think
now,
it's good.
No, this is a hot ass take. Like,
no, honestly, I think it's overhyped. It's overrated. It's when Disney was switching over. Like, you had the OGs, like Finding Nemo, great film. Like, you had OG movies like that.
She called it a film.
That's because I've been hanging around.
An animated movie.
No,
a film. Because there's a difference between a film and a movie. Yeah. A film is a work of art. A movie.
I know.
It's just a long video. Anyway.
Tell us why do you think
it's overrated?
I think that that's when Disney started switching. You know, they were the OG classics, right? And then Ratatouille came out. And it's just overhyped. Everybody's like, oh my God, I love that cute little Remy the rat. Like, just no. I'm sorry. I don't think it's that cute. I don't think that's funny. But like, I don't like animated movies. Majority of them. Nemo, different story. So adorable. But like most animated films and shows, I don't really care
for. What about SpongeBob?
What about SpongeBob? Toy Story?
SpongeBob made me feel rebellious because my mom was one of the moms that was like, you can't watch SpongeBob.
Yeah.
So because he said the word stupid. So shout out Wendy if you're listening. But then I watched it anyway. So,
but do you like SpongeBob? True
Rebel. Yeah, so I think SpongeBob. I think SpongeBob's good. SpongeBob, good comedy, yeah, right, okay, there.
I was gonna say
Toy Story, great instrument.
Wait, what was it?
Whoever drives the white sedan left your lights on is mayonnaise an instrument.
Like, I think SpongeBob is probably one of the most timeless shows.
It is. It connects.
Still
it connects
playing the clarinet, Squiddy.
As you can see, everyone knows at least two quotes, three quotes from this show.
Oh, yeah.
You
know,
should we do it? Should we do it?
Do what? Oh, my God.
What's happening
now? Now that we're men, we can do anything. Now that we're men, we are invincible. Now that we're men, we'll go to Shell City and get the crown and save the town or Mr. Krabs.
For context, Jacob and I were SpongeBob and Patrick for Halloween from the SpongeBob
from the
movie.
SpongeBob movie.
Did you
I
watch
was sexy
the movie?
Patrick.
Oh, I watched the movie. Okay. I had the video game, the SpongeBob the video,
oh, the video game.
Movie.
That game was the
fire.
No, Jacob was sexy Patrick and I was sexy SpongeBob Patrick.
Wait, how did I miss this? Where were y'all?
We I think we were all at the same party, right?
Oops.
I reckon.
Apparently.
But that was a time. That was a while ago. Anyway,
well,
wait,
that
sorry.
Was October, so that was 4 months ago.
We don't want to we don't want to get off track.
Anyways, so Ratatouille
calls during the podcast. What is this? Ratatouille.
Put them on.
Can't cut it off.
Answer.
It's Tim.
Oh, never mind. Oh. I thought it was Philly.
Okay.
Okay. Anyway.
Anyways.
He's
making so,
me again. I'm just gonna
so
text him.
Ratatouille wasn't a good movie.
No, it wasn't. And
really,
I think
the
I just
part
don't
where
like
that part didn't get you going. Didn't make you feel emotional. Or like when the critic has his meal and it's like the flashback to the childhood. That didn't do nothing for you.
No.
Heartless.
Okay.
Heartless.
You could say I'm heartless. A lot of people think that.
The thing is, I
it's okay.
The thing is, are. I don't have a super strong opinion on Ratatouille. Like,
no,
I liked
mean,
it, but
no,
I, it
people
wasn't,
have so they have but, such yeah. a strong opinion on it, and everybody's like, it's the greatest film ever. And
actually,
I'm just like, I'm sorry, no.
Sachita and Alina both love that movie, and when you
no,
brought it up at the Super Bowl party, yes.
No, they were trying to fight me. I was like, I'm sorry. It's just not like it is. It's just overhyped. Like, I'm sorry. It's just, and I think it just boils down, like, I'd rather watch, like, a, like, non-animated movie. Like, I just
That's
would.
Fair.
Well, like, Toy Story wasn't animated. That was real.
I mean, but that,
yeah,
again, was
yeah.
one of the Disney
that was a
classics.
Real movie.
That was one of the Disney classics.
Oh,
there we go.
Oh.
Justin for me. Thank
anyway,
you.
Okay.
No, I mean, I feel, I mean, I kind of agree with you. Like, I don't think Ratatouille was necessarily worth the hype. Like, don't get me wrong. It's a
good movie.
It's a good movie,
but, it's,
but
not,
it's not like,
it's not anything crazy.
It's not like earth shattering where it's like,
yeah,
I love you, Remy. Like, I want to be just like you. I want to be just like you, Linguini. Like, I don't really.
All right. So if we were to really rate care. This take from 1 to 10, Jacob, would you
how
rate
hot
it?
Is it?
How hot is it?
Okay. So 1 being like 0 degrees Kelvin.
Yes.
And 10 being the center of our sun.
Yes.
3.
No, give an example for 3.
What you order me?
Yeah,
three.
Give us a
like,
hot take.
Like I'd
give
say that
a
from if 0 is 0 degrees Kelvin and
uh-huh.
10 is the center of our sun, then it's like I'd say it's like if you turned my electric stovetop maybe to like 8. So.
Okay.
Like a 3.
Sure.
Comparatively. Okay, let's hear the next one.
So what's the next one?
Okay, let me think. What was my other one? Okay, well, Phil and I got Chick-fil-A today, and
okay.
so we were talking about this, and he says that this is a scorching hot take, but I think Chick-fil-A sauce is better than cane sauce. I think
yes.
Chick-fil-A, it's unmatched, and the boys down below have very strong opinions
really?
About that. Very like they think Cane's is the best thing since sliced bread.
No,
see, I can't have a good opinion on this because I didn't grow up around a Cane's.
I didn't either.
Only, but I will say that cane sauce is pretty basic.
It is, dude. It's literally just that like Thousand Island dressing.
And
it's
I wish their menu
ketchup,
was
mayo,
bigger.
And pepper.
Cane's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, like that's the thing. Is like it's like Cane's chicken fingers. It's not like.
I love chicken fingers. I
yeah.
eat them. That's the only thing I can cook. So like that's all I eat.
Does Phil cook for you?
Devin cooks for the both of us. Shout out Devin.
Shout out Devin.
Oh, brother.
Literally shout out Devin. I told
wow.
Phil, I was like, I'm gonna really make him a good Valentine's dinner meal, and then I realized I couldn't cook, so I had to recruit Devin. And so Devin lied to him and said he was on the way to some runner's club meeting, and he came over and we made steaks, and by we I mean Devin. And Devin wore a tux. Devin wore a tux and served us. This was on Tuesday night.
Oh my god,
it was really good.
Wow. Shout out Devin.
Devin, he's a great cook. He says he's gonna start cooking for people.
So Phil knows that Devin made the steaks.
Oh yeah, Devin was in the tux serving Philip. He's fully aware. Wow. It was a good time. It was a great time.
That's pretty sick. Okay, but back to the cane sauce thing. I will say this, though. While cane sauce is not that good, I also don't think Chick-fil-A sauce is that good either.
Oh, that's actually scorching hot take.
No, because it's not bad, but it's...
I'm going to have to fight you on that
one. No, because it's just barbecue sauce.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
It's barbecue sauce with mayonnaise in it or something. No, it's not. That makes mayonnaise. It lighter.
Mayonnaise.
No, but it's not anything crazy.
Yeah, it is.
They didn't invent the fucking wheel. It's just, yeah, it's barbecue sauce. It's like a light barbecue sauce.
It is the Lord's chicken.
Okay, so explain to me why it's a good sauce. Because I genuinely don't care for it that much.
Because it tastes good, bro.
It's sweet, but not too sweet.
It's sweet and
different. It's
and
different
savory.
Than like ketchup and like all the other ones.
Bro, I like Chick-fil-A sauce so much, I had to go to the grocery store and give me a bottle.
I think ketchup's underrated. I think people dog on ketchup too much.
Nah, ketchup's fine. I just like, it reminds me of little kids with like ketchup just all over their face. Like kids smell like ketchup. Like they do. Little kids just smell like ketchup. I'm sorry.
Yo, you know what my cousin used to do when he was a kid? He would eat his Kraft macaroni with ketchup.
That's actually nasty.
Ketchup, if used correctly, can be amazing.
Yeah.
Not just a straight condiment, like with cooking.
Yeah, no. Ketchup's
a little acidic.
Ketchup's tight. Mustard sucks.
No, wait, hold.
No,
like
it does
that
not.
Is the worst condiment ever.
No. Okay, wait. Yellow mustard or like Dijon mustard? What?
Yellow?
All of it.
Okay.
I sit up for
all,
this.
No. This brings me to my next take. Okay, that mustard is absolutely disgusting. But the only mustard I will eat is honey mustard from Bojangles. I don't think y'all know what a Bojangles
is. I've never
been
to Bojangles.
Okay, well, it's
I know what it is.
Anything.
I've never been there.
Okay, well, it is better than Chick-fil-A. It's better than Cane's. It's immaculate. And they have honey mustard, mm-hmm. and it's really sweet, and that's what I like. But any other mustard, yellow, I think is so nasty. It literally is disgusting. Dijon mustard, just because they put a funky, fun name in front of it, like, doesn't make it any better.
It's
like,
different.
It still
it's
sucks.
Different.
No.
It's different. It's
okay, okay, wait, hold up. So I think this is time to do, I want to do a condiment ranking, like a condiment draft.
Okay,
if
like
you were
that.
To draft your top five condiments,
oh, shit.
Like general condiments, not, mm-hmm. actually, no, it can be specific. You could say, like, this from this place.
Okay.
Actually, no, you can't. No, general condiments. Because then you could be like, well, Bojangles honey mustard's good, but every other honey mustard sucks. You have to pick a full category. I really want to know.
Like a type of condiment.
Because I feel like this is, people are very, what's the word?
Polarized,
but no, they're very like
passionate
and personal about their condiment choice.
No, it tells a lot about a person.
It does.
What,
okay,
what
so
like.
I we'll start with you, Grace. If top five.
Top five. Well, top number five one through four is ranch dressing. I will put that on anything. Like, that is...
All of it?
No, all of it. No, like, no, I will eat... No. At one
were
through
you,
four is ranch.
Were you,
like,
that, were you that kid in middle school who would drench their pizza in ranch?
Well, okay.
You look like a ranch kid.
Well, I'm... Like, I don't know what that says about me, but people who like ranch are hot. I've just heard, like, that's what somebody said. So, but no, that was me. I don't love pizza. I think the tomato sauce is like, I'd rather have a cheese stick than a slice of pizza.
Oh, wow. These are hot. Oh, you just keep coming.
Like, I mean, these are just coming to me.
All right, thanks, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Anyways, we'll see you next week. Yeah, get the fuck out of the studio.
No, like, I would, I think it's the tomato sauce. Like, I don't really love it.
What about like a pizza with like white sauce on it? You ever had like a buffalo chicken pizza with buffalo sauce?
Yeah, I mean, like,
stuff?
Like, I'm not gonna be like, I really want a buffalo chicken pizza. Like, that's
okay,
just
that's fair. Okay, no. So ranch. No, ranch is number one. You
so
gotta
ranch,
pick four more.
But yeah, I would put it on my pizza. So like, that's
okay.
It makes pizza a little more tolerable.
Okay, that's fair.
So ranch, and then, I don't really care. Like, literally, I dip everything in ranch. I'm not even joking. Like, fries, pizza, chicken tenders, dinosaur chicken tenders, like, tater tots. No, that's, well, dino nuggets. You know, that's the only thing I eat.
Do you actually, do you have a stock of dino nuggets in your fridge?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Dude, I gotta get some.
No, absolutely. A little
throwback.
Yeah, we should.
No, that's absolutely all I eat. Thank God I have an air fryer.
Do you like bite their heads off first and then like, or do you just eat the whole thing?
I can't put that whole thing in my mouth. That's a lot. I'd be choking.
Or like you bite their legs. I know some, like when I was a kid, I used to bite their legs off first and then I would bite their head off and then I would eat the rest of it.
So you were almost a psycho. You were almost a serial killer. You were almost.
Wait, so then you just bite it? Like,
that's not. Yeah, fun. I just. No, they're crispy. The dinosaur. No, I feel so strongly about this that the dinosaur nuggets taste better than regular chicken nuggets because they have the little, like, you know, legs. And so you can get extra crispiness around it. Like, that's just fact. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. That's just fact.
No, that's a good observation. I don't think I've ever thought of it like that. But.
Okay, so 1 through 4 ranch. That's
so just somehow a hot
take. And then 5 ketchup. Like, I guess, you know.
Not even like, I guess, yeah.
Not even like barbecue? You know, not like even North Carolina sauce? Barbecue?
I mean, I like barbecue sauce, but.
Doesn't North Carolina have like their own special sauce?
Like, what do you mean? North Carolina sauce?
Like North Carolina barbecue is supposed to be like different than other types?
No, North Carolina barbecue. That hits home. At home, when we had that at Med Ball,
is that what that was?
It was like not the same, but like they tried, and so like I'll like give them kudos for that. It was good.
That's fair. It was decent food at Med Ball.
It was.
I also have never had like good barbecue before, and we still haven't gone to. Have you been to Rudy's here?
No, I haven't. I need to go.
I want to try it because I haven't had. I've never had ribs before because I can only eat obviously beef ribs.
Yeah,
but I've heard beef ribs can be really good. I just never.
If they're done well, they're really good. Well. So we gotta. But we should try. Yeah, we should get brisket.
Okay,
but
anyway.
Yeah, field trip to Rudy's.
What's your top 5? This should be easy. I feel like everyone should just have this ready.
I know. I was not prepared.
Top 5 condiments.
Start with number 1.
Number 1. Okay. So, you can't put it on everything.
Okay.
But when you do put it on stuff, it's fire, dog.
Okay.
The chili garlic sauce.
Wait.
The spicy one?
From what?
Like, from where? From what where? Are you talking about?
Isn't it the same brand as sriracha, I think?
Chili garlic? Wait, are you talking about the one in the tub?
Yeah.
That's not. You mean sambal?
Yeah, sambal.
Oh.
It has
garlic in it?
Yeah, it says chili. Bro, go get some out of your fridge.
I don't have any. I ran out. Yeah. Okay, that shit is fire, though. I can't lie. Mm. That is.
I don't use it very often. It's
called sambal olek.
Sambal? I don't know why. I knew it was called sambal, but I couldn't remember. Anyways, I don't put that on, like, I don't use it very often, but when I do, I'm like, oh, this is so good. It's, like, sweet. Let's say a little sweet, spicy. It's just, I don't know. It's so good.
Okay. Yeah, I don't think you have to use it for everything for it to be like a good.
No. And then after that, probably go ranch.
Hell yeah, brother.
And then barbecue sauce. And then cheese sauce.
Please tell me you're not like an easy cheese.
No, I'm talking about like
the spray actual cheese kind of guy. No, please tell me.
Okay, I'm talking about like actual real cheese sauce when you go to a restaurant.
Like queso.
Yeah, but like just generalized.
It's just melted cheese with like cream and stuff.
Yeah.
I don't think that's a sauce.
Do you like spray cheese?
I've had it and it literally tastes like plastic.
Okay, good.
Okay, you look like you would like spray cheese.
No. And then number 5,
you're thinking way too much.
I'm going to have to go with Dijon mustard.
Wow. Okay.
Because it's classy.
I'm going to say something that's going to piss you guys off.
What?
I'm not saying ranch is bad. But I just... It's overhyped.
No, it's because of the utility.
No,
it's so versatile. It is versatile.
Gives it a higher ranking.
No.
Yes.
No, but the utility is it doesn't. It just makes whatever you're dipping in it taste like ranch and not like what it's supposed to be.
That's not true.
I mean, are you dunking it in it? Like,
you might as well just drink it.
No.
I would drink it. I mean, I would.
When Grace is on her deathbed, she just wants an IV of Hidden Valley Ranch coursing through her veins.
Wait, what's your favorite ranch brand then?
Oh, Hidden Valley, for sure.
Really?
For sure.
I think that's one of the worst ones.
Well, you don't even like ranch, so your opinion is not valid. I'm sorry.
I don't know if the camera's picking it up right now, but there are fumes coming off the top.
No, like literally, No.
I just said it's not bad. It's just not, like, I'll eat ranch, but I don't go to it for most things.
Oh, no, like, I have to buy a bottle a week. I am going through that, baby.
Like, okay, with wings, it's great.
Yeah.
Low-key, blue cheese is better.
Oh, no, that's scorching hot take. Blue cheese is disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. I would rather not eat than eat blue cheese. Like, it is crumbly, and, like, it literally, like, looks like just, like, rotten, like, bacteria just fermenting somewhere. I mean, it is nasty.
It's moldy a little bit.
No, it is disgusting. That's why it's blue.
Yeah, that's the point.
No,
I think it's good. I like the taste of it.
You look bad. Like, I'd like blue cheese. I don't know.
I'm getting a stank eye right now.
You should. Like, you deserve it. Maybe I don't know what to tell you.
Really? You don't like... Do you like blue cheese?
Not particularly.
Am I the only person? Because like Alina and Chita both chat on me for liking blue cheese too.
Yeah.
Because we got like Wingstop and I was like, can we get some blue cheese dressing? And they just got... No, blue cheese dressing. I don't like blue cheese by itself. Like,
okay, no. Even the dressing. Like, nothing makes me more pissed off than when I am eating a wing and I dip it in, because they look the same, right? So true. It's like, oh, they're pranking me. I swear to God. Like, I'm like, ranch, please, on the side. Then you dip it in, like nothing. That'll just ruin your day.
That's
right,
fair. Because you're expecting one thing and cool. then you get another.
It's a horrible aftertaste.
Well,
yeah, blue cheese is just not good.
Okay. Well, I like it, so.
Yeah, well, you're wrong.
And I'm not going to push that on anyone. You don't have to eat blue cheese just because I like blue cheese, but I think it's pretty good. Okay, anyway, you want to hear my ranking?
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Number one, soy sauce. That's it.
Okay, that's fair.
Soy sauce. It's like the most, it is the most versatile condiment known to me.
Yeah,
but okay, you can use it for dipping into stuff.
Yeah, but I would rather mix it with something.
Like, well, that, no. It's add it. So
instead
it's,
of just like soy
it's
sauce.
Like, it's like, you know, when people add Parmesan, it's like the salt. It's like if you want something to be saltier, but you don't want to just add salt, you add like, if there's calls for cheese, you add Parmesan cheese because it's salty and you get the cheesiness. Same with soy sauce. It's liquid salt. And so you don't have to salt, but it makes your salt, and it's, you know, it's just, I don't know. I think it's amazing. I use it literally, I go through, that's what I go through bottles of.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
And there's dark soy sauce and then light soy sauce and sweet soy sauce.
Oh, I didn't know there was a difference.
Oh, dark. Oh, yeah.
Dark's good.
Dark
soy sauce is very good.
Yeah. And it's, you know, when you get like noodles and they're like a dark brown,
mm-hmm.
it's because of that. Because dark soy sauce doesn't have that much of a flavor, but it's more for color.
Soy sauce, that's good. That's a good one.
Okay. And then honestly, that's it.
You know what's really good? The mayo, yum sauce. Yes. That sauce. Okay.
I actually had yum yum sauce for dinner. I had it with my dinner.
That's the hibachi sauce.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's really. That's actually QP mayo.
Specifically. Have you had QP mayo before?
No.
Okay. Do you like mayonnaise?
Yeah. I love mayonnaise.
Okay. So QP mayo. Nice. Do you know how mayonnaise is made, right? Because some people think it's disgusting.
Wait, no, I don't. I'm scared. Am I going to like something?
I don't want to ruin mayonnaise for you.
You're not.
Do you like eggs?
Yeah. Okay, I go through a phase where you love it or hate it. This is what mayonnaise is.
Ready? It's eggs.
No, it's egg yolks.
No, well, QP is. But normal mayonnaise is just, it's an egg. Mm-hmm. It's eggs and oil emulsified together.
Emulsification, baby. Yeah.
No, literally what it is. It's literally, they just take, you can make it. You just drop, and it's raw.
Like, okay.
Yeah, so you just drop some eggs, and then you drop oil, and then you blend it, and then you get mayonnaise. It's actually so easy to make, but yeah. QP mayonnaise is made with only egg yolks. So it's like creamier.
It's richer. Oh,
it's so good. I keep like smacking the mic with my face, but it's so good. It's so good. It's a Japanese mayonnaise.
Dude, QP and ramen?
I have some. I'm going to give you some.
It'll change your life.
It's hard to get, though.
Game changer, brother.
Okay. You have any other hot takes?
I do have one more that people might hate on me for, but I don't like The Office. I don't like it. I like actually don't like it. I think Friends is better than The Office.
Oh no, you shouldn't have said that. You could have just said you didn't like The Office, but Friends is better.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Really? I'm sorry. I think that it's just so like the. I think the reason that I don't like it is because of like the whole breaking the fourth wall thing or whatever when they stare at the camera like this. Like it just, I don't get it. Like I think it just. I think it's just like awkward. It stresses me out. My hands get clammy. I don't like watching The Office. It's like,
is it
secondhand embarrassment kind of thing?
And so, what is it then that you like about Friends?
Oh, it's just top tier comedy. Top tier comedy. Really? Like Monica and Chandler, love them. I mean, who doesn't want to look at? I forgot her name, but like, you know,
Jennifer Aniston.
Yes, Jennifer. Yes,
she's hot. Rachel in the show.
She's hot.
Yes, I mean, who doesn't want to look at 90s Rachel all day, or Jennifer Aniston?
I think Friends has zero on the scale of comedy. I have watched episodes of Friends, and I think it's stupid.
That's a hot take. That's a hot take.
I will die on that hill.
No, that is actually very hot take.
I do not like Friends whatsoever.
Really?
I think there's like a group of people who are like die hard Friends fans and like can only like have Friends merch and like,
are you one of them?
Like I'm not one of those people that's like, oh, I want to go like sit on the couch that they all sat on and like fake drink coffee. Like, no, that's not me. But like, I'm just saying that show is just better than The Office. I don't think The Office is funny. I've never laughed at The Office, and I've watched it multiple times. It stresses me out. It's just like awkward. Like, not my vibe.
Have you seen The Office?
Yeah, no, I love The Office.
Would you like to form an alliance with me?
Yes.
I don't even think you're saying the line right. I thought yes. Yes, I would.
No. I wasn't saying the line. I was just saying yes. But I will say this because I want to touch on this. I'm in the middle because I like Friends. I think it has its place.
No.
What?
I was checking my list of hot takes. You have to address it. No, I've been writing them down.
I think that it has a place. Like it has some funny moments. Like Pivot, that's a classic, right? Honestly, only moment I remember from the show. Never watched it all the way through, but I have seen The Office all the way through. And the reason why I think The Office is better is because I watched this video on YouTube where someone took out all the laugh tracks from a Friends episode. And so they would, you know, someone would walk in, or I don't know, Chandler would walk in and be like, what's up, guys? And then.
Okay, but that's not how the show actually was.
And then with the laugh track, it's like. and then they would say like 10 more words and then pause again. And it was too much. I can't do laugh tracks. I think that they have some funny moments, but I can't do laugh tracks. It takes away.
I can't do long pauses.
That breaks the fourth wall.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't say it did.
You know what? What's a fun fact about laugh tracks?
What?
I don't know if it's still true, but I heard it and I believed it. But a lot of the laugh tracks that are in TV shows are like decades old recordings.
Oh yeah, they probably
so it's just a bunch of dead people laughing.
Yeah.
Oh, that's weird.
That's
weird.
I mean, but I can see that. Yeah.
Suck on those apples.
But I will say that a lot of the humor in Office is very. It's
dry
niche.
Humor.
It's niche and it's
but
dry.
But I like dry
and
humor.
And if you don't like that kind of, it won't.
I think
won't
it's just
like
awkward.
It. So I get why people don't like The Office. Dude, but I don't get why people love Friends.
My brother loves The Office.
Oh, it's a great show.
I mean, people like literally just, that's the only show they'll watch. And I'm like, okay.
No, I watched it once. I won't rewatch it. I don't rewatch stuff.
But like Friends is a good thing where you can have, like, I think you should watch it through so you can like see the relationships develop. But like you can have that on while you're eating dinner. Like it's just something in the background. The Office is just like, it's not going to do it for me.
That's fair. Have you seen other like comedy, new age comedy shows?
Have you seen Parks and Rec?
Yeah, like Parks and
Rec. I haven't seen Parks and Rec, but what? I absolutely love New Girl. So like, oh, I feel like that's the same. Okay. Like I love New Girl.
New Girl is great. New Girl is a great show. Actually, we were literally watching, we were showing Alina when they were playing True American.
Oh, such a great game.
I want to learn how to play it and we should play it.
No, we're playing it.
Apparently there are rules out for it.
No, yeah. And you can like make, my friends and I did this in college. Like you can just like make up your own rules too and just like call it True American.
Have you seen New Girl, Jacob?
I haven't watched it all the way through, but I've seen some episodes.
Mm. Have you watched it all the way through?
Yeah.
So we were having this discussion last night, actually.
Let me preface. I think I didn't watch the last season, but I know what happened.
Okay. Do you think that Nick and Jess should have ended up together? I think...
No.
Oh, that's a hot... See, that's a hot take. The boys wanted her to end up with Reagan... Nick to end up with Reagan. Mm-hmm. But I think that's just because they think Megan Fox is hot. And Philip, if you're watching this, I know that it's just because you think Megan Fox is hot. So, dude, and you just wanted to see... He just wants to see more of her on the TV screen because that's the only chance in life he'll get to interact with Megan Fox. But Nick and Jess were perfect for each other.
I think that's part of the show, though, is them not being together at the end of it. Like, or not, sorry, it's like,
or like all throughout.
Yeah, I think that the way that it ended, because that's honestly why I didn't finish it, because I heard a lot of people weren't happy with the way that it ended.
I was a happy customer.
And I
was worth my Netflix subscription.
Because they started as friends, and it ends as friends, you know? Like, I feel like... I think we could talk a lot about
this.
But I feel bad, because Jacob doesn't know what we're talking about.
Sorry, okay. Jacob. It's because you Dijon mustard.
Hey, I like Dijon. What else was on your list?
Okay. This was my last hot take. Just anime in general.
Oh God.
Just anime in general.
Can we skip that one?
Wait,
cause
do you know whose house you're in?
No. This is like, I started watching, I don't know. You're going to have to ask Devin what it is, but it was very sexual. It was very sexual. Like a really weird one.
Is it about cooking?
No, I don't know. It was scaring me, but that was the first one. But I love Avatar, The Last Airbender. Okay, that's a great one.
That's fair.
But I haven't seen the other ones. But like I've only had glimpses of it, and it scares me.
Really?
Yeah, it's scary. Like it was like weird. Like it was like also they're at like you actually have to ask Devin about this because it's like a really niche one. He was like, "This is not the first one you should be watching," but it was like
weird. That's the thing about anime. I think it scares a lot of people. There's like starter animes.
Yeah, I think I needed a better starter one.
Like I don't watch anime. I don't know why.
I thought it was called anime. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, I don't really watch anime very much. Mm-hmm. No, I don't really watch a whole lot of anime, but I've watched some, either like series or like
we started an anime together at the start of the year. We never.
Yeah, no, it just kind of fell apart.
Whatever. You should go back and watch it.
I probably will
because the new season's coming out soon.
Anyways, I watched a movie. What was it called? Akira.
Oh, you watched Akira?
Yeah. That's a good one.
It's a great
movie. That's like a pretty good starter one.
It is, yeah.
I think
I've Or have you seen, like, one. You know what Dragon Ball Z is?
I know what it is, but I haven't watched it.
Yeah, Dragon Ball Z is
an anime. My brother watched it. I grew up watching Dragon Ball Z. I had no idea it was an anime.
It was just the one. Did you grow up
playing Dragon Ball Z video games?
Oh, yeah, 100%. Oh,
fuck yeah, bro.
Dude, Budokai Tenkaichi 3.
Oh!
On the Wii, and you would go, you just...
Dude, me and my brother would play that, and then we would get in fist fights.
Game was sick. Okay, wait, I want to change your mind. I really want to change your mind.
Can I don't know what it's called, and I literally just want to call Devin and ask. Show you. But it's something where the...
What was going on?
A girl, they were like... A girl and a guy kissed, and she like threw up in his mouth, and he like really wanted to kiss. Like it was weird.
What the fuck would Devin show you?
No, like I don't know.
Know what you're talking about, and I've seen a lot of anime.
No, it was something like so strange. I was like, "What is going on?"
Why did this happen?
It was something about like she was really drunk and like, but he wanted to kiss some other girl. Like it was the weirdest thing going on. Like I have no idea, but. Philip and them watched it the whole way through.
Was it a movie or was it a show?
No, it's a show.
They watched every episode.
They watched it on their like anime account, like you know the on
Crunchyroll.
Yes.
Of course, I gotta. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, wait.
No, so no, it's this, on there. It's this, on there.
This makes me. This. No, I'm sad now. I feel like I could change your mind though.
I feel like my mind could be changed, but it was a horrible experience.
You don't like animated stuff,
right? So and I think that like
why you don't like animated stuff.
I don't know. Maybe it's some trauma. I don't know. Like I don't know what's going on.
Because I know there are a lot of people who don't like who are just averse to all like animated movies or just animated stuff in general. And
yeah,
and they'll make exceptions for like SpongeBob here and there. But
yeah, I think I fall into that category.
Okay.
Or like,
would you allow me to possibly try to change your mind?
No. Yeah, I'm so down.
What's the one we watched
We watched a few episodes of Attack on Titan.
No. We watched a couple weeks ago. How's Moving Castle?
Oh, How's Moving Castle.
That's,
yeah.
That's a good movie.
That's a great movie.
Yeah.
There's also some, but yeah, but there's a, there, I, there are good starter animes that I don't think, that I think everyone should start. Obviously, they're starter animes. And not, there's, because there's some weird shit out there. There's some
weird. It was anime. Weird and it scared me. And I was like, no.
Yeah. That, I don't, yeah, I don't know. I don't know what the fuck that was, but I don't think that was a good place to start.
It wasn't. You're going to have to ask him. Like,
seriously. I'm going to, because.
Yeah, when we all hang out tonight, we need to rip him a new one.
Was there like demons and shit in it too?
No, I don't really, like, I literally just was scarred from that moment. And so there was a lot, it was violent, but.
It was violent? I actually think I might know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
But I don't remember anyone throwing up in anyone's mouth.
It was weird. It was really
there's
weird.
A show called Devilman Crybaby. Was that it?
I don't know the name, but it was like his first kiss too. And so then it was weird. I don't know.
Wait, actually, I think I may know what you're talking about. Okay, yeah. There's a show called Devilman Crybaby. It's weird as fuck. It's actually a really good show when you watch the whole thing. But yeah, it's about this guy who literally just, he's a devil. He can turn into a devil.
Wait. Yeah, but, I think it might be that. And it was his
but
like.
He cries all the time.
Like I don't
after
remember.
He kills and stuff, he'll just weep.
I don't know. I think I just like zoned out and watched TikTok. After
and there was
that,
some. But. There was a lot of that. You will rarely find animes where people like kiss or there's any sort of sexual stuff going on. That's one of the ones that
makes the exception.
Okay, and
then
that
I think
is
it might
not
be that
at all a starter anime.
Okay, then
I would
good.
Never recommend anyone watch that until you've watched it a decent amount. And you understand because like there's certain things about anime you just have to like understand. And you have to get over.
I think I just like need to erase that from my memory.
Okay, what else?
We'll talk about that. And that was my last one, I think.
That was your last one?
That was
okay,
my last one.
Should we
one.
Transition into, this is the one I'm excited for the most.
No, this is 2 + 2 = 5 with Sparky.
2 + 2 = 5 with Sparky.
This is what doesn't add up to me. I mean, just simply, these are things that I'd like to talk about that just don't make sense. Okay. The first one, I've been thinking of this a lot recently. I'm in medical school, yet this does not make sense to me. Traffic. I do not know how traffic, like, okay, like minus like a car accident or something, but or like construction, okay, but like just go. It does. No, actually, okay, especially the exit. I don't know the roads. I have to use a GPS everywhere, but like, when I'm exiting off to go to the flats or like exiting 3 onto Loman, it gets so backed up. I don't know why. There's no stoplight. There's nothing right there. Just go.
I have an answer for you.
Oh, okay. Are you about to change my life right
now? Do you want the like objective reason why or like the real reason why?
Both.
Okay. The objective reason is because people's reaction times are so bad.
Trash.
They're horrible. And also, people are just bad drivers. Everyone's a bad driver. No one is a good driver. I don't care what anyone says. Everyone's a bad driver.
No, I'm a bad driver. I'll openly admit that.
Anyone who tries to tell you that they're a good driver is just not true. They're good at driving in circles. That's not the same. I'm talking about driving on like normal roads, surface roads, with other cars around, with lights and all that shit. That everyone's a bad driver. And the reason why is because literally traffic could start by with one car just like brakes for a second and everyone's going the same speed and they're moving together. One car brakes for a second. It's going to take a little bit of time for the car behind them to realize and then they're going to stop. And then now the car next to them is going to then take a little second and then they're going to stop. They don't all just stop at the same time because people's reaction times suck. So then that person stops and then the next one and then it just builds up. And it could be miles back where then the actual traffic will start. And then it's literally because everyone is sequentially stopping later and later and later and
but
for
like
longer and longer.
Somebody can just change it. Like, I mean, just somebody can just go and then have a better reaction time.
And that circles back to why everyone is a bad driver.
I mean, that's fair. That's fair. But like, it irritates me to absolutely no end. Yeah. Absolutely.
And then even when there are accidents and they clear them off the street, it's because bobbleheads.
Then there's another car accident because people are looking. They're like, "Oh, what just happened?"
That's the worst. When people when they think something's happening, so they'll just stop, and then a mile back, it'll cause a giant traffic buildup. It's horrible. It's the more cars, and then the reason why it happens more at like rush hour and stuff is just the more cars, the more likely it's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone just, their reaction times suck. That's
well, thank you for teaching me today.
Because there was actually this video I saw where it showed, okay, here's one car stopping, which will lead to then another car stopping, but for a little bit longer, and then the next car for a little bit longer, and then a little bit longer, and a little bit longer, and then eventually builds up to, it's just, everyone's just stopped.
Or if everybody could just merge with some sense.
This is why, well, yeah. Well, that's the other thing. One bad merge. Oh. But this is why self-driving cars are the future. Traffic would go away. Because computers have perfect reaction time. Imagine a world with no traffic. That'd be amazing.
You know what I also don't like about the drivers here? Mm. This might just be a North Carolina thing, but like when I let you over, why don't you wave back at me? Like I wave if somebody lets me in. Like that is just what happens in North Carolina. Not one
courtesy wave. You
always give a courtesy wave. Nobody in New Mexico. I've not gotten one courtesy wave in New Mexico.
Let's see it. Let's see your wave. I feel like everyone's perfect. This is what you do?
Yeah, I'm like, oh, good. Hey, thanks. And if they don't wave, then I like a wave back. Like communicate. We're all human. We love interaction.
What about you? Let's see your wave, Jacob. That's the wave.
That's such a dad wave.
I do the classic. I'm just like.
It's such a dad wave.
Very, very. How does your hand go up that? You smack your your roof.
You know what my favorite dad hand movement is?
What?
When they ask for the check, they just see the waiter or the waitress and they make eye contact.
Yeah.
That was slick. You've done that before. Sent your first
or the
radio.
The autoboy is like, and everyone just makes a mad dash with their wallets out. They're like, I'll pay.
Oh my God, and they're fighting over it.
Everyone wants to pay, but in reality, no one wants to pay. Everyone wants to think they want to pay. Yeah.
You're right.
It's a vicious cycle. But anyway, okay, so that is...
So traffic, you've just solved it. No.
It still doesn't make sense. It shouldn't happen.
The thing that really bothers me about traffic is like if you're like on the freeway and like there's a backup and then you get to the like point where the backup should be and then like all the cars are in front of you and you're like, oh, so everybody just decided to step on the gas? Like,
no, yeah. Like, that's...
What do I mean?
No.
Yeah.
Doesn't make any sense.
Next time you stop at a red light, okay? And you're stopped at a red light, it's going to turn green and just watch how long it takes for the car in front of you to start going.
Okay.
They will literally like...
It's my homework assignment from the pod.
That's why there's those people who will, if they want to merge... They'll pull up next to you at the stoplight, and then the minute it turns green, they just and get right in front of you because they're ready for it. But most people aren't paying attention.
No.
Or they're just like dozing off, and then it turns green, they're like,
I guess I should go now.
Oh, okay, let's go.
Yeah, just pay attention to that, and it'll blow your mind how bad people are at driving. If you just observe. Yes. Okay,
Wait, but can we also talk about, did you see on Osborne's recording how he was saying that like in China, he's not sure if this is true, so I don't know why he was telling us, but he said that people, if you have to go to the bathroom, they have somebody come up like on a moped and like sit in your car for you if you're stuck in traffic to let you go to the bathroom and you take the moped to go. Like this in China or something.
What?
I've never heard of this. He's like, you haven't heard of it? I was like, no, sir.
Wait, he brought this up in class, in lecture. This is what you guys do in the flip lecture? You don't actually talk about
this. He said that if you're stuck in traffic in China, you call someone.
And they come up like on a moped.
Yeah,
but
how does the moped get through traffic?
No, you take the moped to go to the bathroom.
The moped goes around like
the
shoulders and stuff.
The person sits in your car.
Why would you trust someone to do
that? No, that's what I was saying. He was like, I don't know if this is true, but I heard that somewhere.
So then how do they get back? Do they just go the wrong way?
Like, how do they know where? Yeah, how do they know where they're going? I have so many questions.
We'll fact check it, and if it's true, if it's not true, then we'll correct ourselves.
That's going to be the title. That's going to be the title of this podcast. Chinese moped bathroom ?
Comment below if this has happened to you.
I feel like people would probably have that assumption of like East Asia because everyone's like they're in the future, like they're always ahead of everyone, and so they're just like, well, it seems like, you know, they would have people to loan you a moped so you could go to the bathroom. I feel like it'd be smarter just put Porta-potties like on the side of the road in the little median area.
I'm afraid of porta-potties. I'm so afraid. Really? One is gonna tip over and I'm just gonna get all that nasty on me.
See,
like, I think that's one of my biggest fears. I'll say it, porta-potties. Like, that's facts.
More than like a bear chasing you?
I mean, if a bear is chasing me and it's my time, it's my time. Like, that's just kind of how I feel.
Lord is calling me.
But if a porta potty tips
but
over.
If a porta potty tips over, I'm running. Like, because that's not gonna kill you, that's just gonna like kill my self-esteem a little bit. But that
they're at being porta potties, the whoever invented those, you're a savior and also the worst person in
the world. They're nasty. Absolutely
nothing
nasty.
Like the plastic potty,
just the stench.
I at least like drain it out somewhere.
I'm scared to.
No, you know what they do, like they're at like an event for however long, or like at a construction site, right? And they get picked up and they get loaded onto a truck and they go back to like the porta potty facility and they get drained and cleaned.
Oh yeah, yeah, there. But I'm saying like drain them as they're being used, because the worst fucking thing ever is when you walk, you're like, I have to use this porta potty, and you walk in and you just look down and you just see piles of shit.
No.
it is like the most disheartening thing you walk in
and you see what looks like the world record biggest shit. And you're just like
piled on top. Okay,
you're like, damn,
this is just, oh.
I really got to do this right now. But I will say the porta potties with the like the little plastic urinal on the
wet porta potty.
Yeah,
they have
a plastic urinal, and I'm afraid I'm gonna touch it on the side because I'm a hoverer. I'm not gonna sit down.
No.
Even in a porta potty, yeah. not just in a porta potty. Even if I'm in Target, like I'm hovering like that. I'm not gonna take the time to lay down that little plastic sheet. I think those are dumb, but. They have a urinal thing on the side. Yeah. No, and I'm afraid, like, when I'm hovering, I'm going to accidentally touch it. And then I'm going to, like, that is going to kill me right there.
See, those are kind of fun to pee in because it, like, goes down and then it, like, trickles. And it kind of...
Wait, does it then go into the main basin and everything else?
And then for a second...
I've never seen that before.
For a second, if you close your eyes, you're like, oh, I'm not in this, like, vile porta potty. You're like, I'm in a nice rainstorm. Like, the nice trickle, you're like, oh...
That's weird. I'm sorry.
You gotta snap away from reality for a second there.
In terms of, because I know with porta potties, at least for me, they're bearable if I just have to pee.
Yeah.
They're bearable. And I know it's different for women. But, because let me preface. I sit when I pee normally. Like most of the time. It's comfortable. This is a hot
take. Is that a hot take?
No, this is a hot take. Look at his face right now. Wait, no. We have to talk about this. No,
I can see where you're coming from.
No. Let me.
Is this a thing that guys sit when they pee? I thought they stand.
No. Because so, I feel like, okay, I'm gonna say.
Let's get it all out right now.
Okay. I'm gonna say so. I think that. A lot of guys hold on to the fact that they can stand when they pee. They can stand when they pee because of the
anatomy.
The anatomy. And they just do it because they're guys. And it like, I don't know, maybe it makes them feel like more masculine or something. But it blows my mind that someone would prefer to stand than sit. Granted that everything is clean, like
so, like even in a pub, like you're in Target, you're gonna sit down.
Okay, depend. So I put toilet paper.
You're one of those people.
Toilet paper and then sit, cause it's just more comfortable. Why would you not? It's more comfortable. It's cleaner.
What do you mean it's cleaner? You're sitting down on the actual
toilet.
Oh, you're not like, making a mess.
As in, you're not making a mess because anyone who says that they have good aim is lying.
No,
because at least one drop will get off. And I saw a video of someone showing how much backsplash there is when you stand and pee into a toilet. This TikTok, okay? There's some weird shit on TikTok. No, and it goes a good foot above the toilet. There will be like splashback, like very like micro splashback that you can't even see. So I'm like, why not sit?
I feel like you have a strong opinion about this. You're like sitting up like a peacock.
It's more comfortable. And especially when I'm at home.
Like,
if I
have to pee in public, like 100% going to stand and use a urinal. Like,
No. This is saying that there isn't a urinal. If there's a urinal, I'll use the urinal.
Yeah.
I'm saying peeing, standing in a toilet, like a normal toilet. Urinal is different. Gotcha. Urinal's different. I would use a urinal.
I don't know. At least for me, I just do it standing because it's quicker. Because, like, most of the time, like, I just hold it until the absolute last second.
Yeah, but then and you can like sit down and you can relax your legs and you can just increase your intra-abdominal pressure and get that shit out.
God, no.
I mean, I'll try it and I'll get back to you.
I want you to try.
Start asking people this question.
This is
a good question.
You will find most people will have a strong opinion on this, guys, and it will usually be that they like to stand.
I'm not saying you're wrong.
I get your point. If you're at home, in your own bathroom, then I don't think there's any reason to stand, because you're not avoiding getting like dirty. It's your own fucking bathroom. Like,
I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna get back to you.
Try it.
I'm gonna get back to you.
It is comfortable.
I think all the viewers should try it.
Yeah. If you're a guy out there and you only stand when you pee and only pee, because we know that not all pee-pee time is poo-poo time, but all
God
pee-pee
damn
time
it.
Is pee-pee time.
So God damn it. I was going to bring that up.
No, but I'm going to say, so that's different. But if you just have to pee, try sitting and it'll change your life.
Yeah, but I think we can all agree that all poo-poo time is pee-pee time, but all pee-pee time is poo-poo time.
No, that's a
universal
that's a
law.
Fact.
That's a universal
fact.
Anyone who says
that's how you know you're done.
Yeah. Anyone who says that they have pooped without peeing before is just lying to
wrong.
You. They're lying to you. They're gaslighting you. They're pushing a false narrative and they're trying to gain something.
Or if they're like, oh, I have to pee. And then when they're done peeing, they realize that they have to poop. And then they go sit down and they poop. But still, a little pee-pee is going to trickle out.
And even if it doesn't, it was still pee-pee time.
It was still pee-pee time.
It was. I was like really thinking. I was sitting over here thinking. I was like, has there ever been a time? No.
Yeah. But back to the porta-potty thing.
You ever heard them called Porta Johns?
Mm-hmm.
I do not like that.
No,
because like
it's a South thing.
People say that the John, like, oh, I gotta hit the John, like it means I gotta go take a shit.
Porta John.
The Porta John means plastic pooper.
Wow.
No, we were talking about this the other day. The South has different sayings.
Completely go. Should we go?
Okay.
Wait, yeah.
Full send.
I want to be
one of my.
I don't know any of these.
One of my favorite ones is. Well, hell, y'all are louder than two skeletons f***ing on a tin roof.
Bro, what the?
It's facts.
No, why was it specific?
Think about a skeleton.
No, I get
on a tin roof.
The thing is, they make sense. It's just like, why use that analogy? Is it for the effect? Like,
sounds
for the...
good. What's the one about the squirrels in the log?
What? Okay, I don't know what you're talking about.
No, is it squirrels or is it something else?
Squirrels.
These are like these are universal like Southern sayings. Yeah. Like if you said that to someone.
Okay, what's the one that your grandma was talking about and Zaina was like, I've never heard that.
The other one I was talking about is, boy, it's hotter than two squirrels fucking in a. Oh no.
No,
it's two things.
It's hotter than two squirrels fucking in a wool sock.
That's not it.
Why are these so sexual? Why is everyone fucking? Why are skeletons?
Bro, I don't know.
I don't know.
And then these are like universal. So if you went to like someone else and you said this, they would like from the South.
Okay,
they would
this
know
is the
it?
Debate we were having earlier because yes. I was like, no, I've never heard this. But Jacob's grandma was like, yes, everybody from
word.
The South should have heard it.
Okay. Yeah,
I know what this is.
Yeah,
I brought it up. I think in a different
cattywampus.
Yeah, I actually wanted to talk to you guys about that. I wanted to have a serious conversation about it.
Let's, first of all, let's consult.
To my knowledge.
Oh, shit, it's already 8:50.
Is it really?
Oh, shit, I was telling people to come over at 9. Oh, brother.
Yeah, Jacob's got the open come through.
I want to say, to my knowledge, it means diagonal.
Okay.
It means diagonal, right?
We're going to the Merriam-Webster's.
It's in
right.
It's in the Webster dictionary?
Yes.
So it's a real word. It's a real word.
I don't think just because it's in the dictionary, I don't think it's a real word. Like ain't is in the dictionary, but it's technically not a real word, right?
What?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's not a real word?
No, it's not. No, I'm
no
like
fucking
that's
way.
Facts.
Actually?
That's facts.
Why is it in the dictionary then?
Well, I don't know. That's just what my third grade teacher told me. She said ain't is not a real word and I should not use that in a paper. And I have not since.
I mean, I can see why you wouldn't want
to. So, cattywampus. Crooked, askew, out of alignment, in disarray, or disorder.
So, can you use it in a sentence, please?
So, my mom used to use it, and she would say, oh, you know, today's Sunday, like, it's, you know, it's the day off. She goes, you know, I'm going to sleep in. I'm not going to do my hair, my makeup. And if people come over to the house and they see me all cattywampus, then so be it. And I said, amen, mama.
Wait, I thought it was a direction thing.
Oh, it also has a direction component. So cattywampus means it's not straight, right? It means it's skew. So if you go down to the Home Depot and you ask Bill, right, and you say, oh, I'm looking for a 3/4-inch concrete drill bit. And he goes, oh, you're in the wrong aisle. If you go, you know, down over yonder, it's just cattywampus around the corner. And you look at him, you say, oh, okay, yeah, all right, yeah, right,
And then you know where it is.
Yes.
I'm going to have to use this expression when I go back to Raleigh, North Carolina, and I'll let you know if anybody knows
what I don't understand why you would. There. Why wouldn't you just say, like, diagonal?
Well, people say over yonder. It's just, it gives it a little more spice.
I guess, yeah.
I am a big fan of over yonder.
I like over yonder.
What are your thoughts on over there, way over yonder?
Wait, what? Over there, way over yonder?
Yeah, over there, way over yonder.
Use it on a regular basis.
Just where the Hollies live? Oh, they live over there, way over yonder.
Yeah.
Just cattywampus to the farm on the
left. No, minus the cattywampus, you were onto something. But like, oh yeah.
Wait, is it wombus or wampus?
Wampus.
Wampus.
What is the origin of this? Does it have like?
I feel like I'm on a spelling bee. Can you spell it for us?
Yeah, it's C A T T Y W A S, or sorry,
W A
C A C A T T Y W A M. P-U-S.
Wampus.
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 Long A. Wampus.
What the... bro, that... Okay, is there like a origin for it? Because most words have like Latin...
No, but then we got into an argument one day, so then I helped call my mom, and she didn't answer, and then I got mad at my mom, because I'm like, what the fuck, mom? You're my mom. You're supposed to answer the phone. What the fuck else are you doing? And then...
No, I feel that.
And then I called her mom, right? And she... Well, her
your grandma,
yeah,
granny.
What do you call your grandma?
Mammy Sally.
Mammy, that is the cutest thing I think.
Her first name Sally. So her and her husband, my grandfather, are Mammy Sally or Mammy for short, and Papa.
That's really cute.
Anyways,
this is another. Okay, wait.
Anyways, I called Mammy Sally and I said, "Look, I am having a debate with some folks that some people would argue are." Some of the highest achieving academics in our country. And they said they don't know what the word cattywampus means. And I said, can you please, and I put her on speaker and I said, can you please explain what cattywampus is? She goes, well, to me, you know, everybody got a little different definition. She said, to me, cattywampus means that it's not straight and it's diagonal and it's over there. And I said, thank you. That's what I need to know.
I would love to talk to this woman.
Okay, I tell you what. My grandparents want to come visit. We need to get both of them on this podcast because that would be five hours long. I call them on the phone and I cannot get off the phone for at least 45 minutes.
Wait, that's actually so cute. I'm like,
I'm like, hey, Mammy, what's up?
They teach me a lot.
And they're like, they just talk. They talk about everything. They just talk about their life. They're like, oh, we just got back from Laughlin. We went on like a little vacation. Your grandpa took me to the casino and we saw a movie and. They think this is like this big grand vacation, but they're just going to a casino, get dinner, watch a movie. I'm like, I love it.
That's how I'm
love
trying it. To be when I'm old.
I mean, I'm down to have them on. I do have this question though, because I think we brought this up the other day that white people
have weird ass names for their grandparents.
Yes.
Oh, that's absolutely
different.
Facts.
Like, they're different. And it's not like makes sense. So can you explain this to me? Because I genuinely don't understand.
So for me, so my dad's parents are like pretty, what's the word? Pretty, not like antiquated, but like old school, right? Yeah. And so I'm the second oldest. My oldest cousin on like that side of the family is 3 months older. And I mean, obviously like 3 months isn't that big of a difference. But like when my aunt was pregnant with my cousin, they told the family, they're like, we... will only respond to grandma and grandpa. Like, you can't call us anything else. And I was like, okay, get to stick out of your ass, loser. Right? But then on my mom's side, so I'm also the second oldest on that side. And then my older cousin, she's 3 years older than me. So obviously, like, she was, like, around first and, like, got to hang out with my grandma first.
Mm-hmm.
And I think she was, I can't remember the exact story, but I think she was, like, they were at, like, a gathering or, like, family dinner or whatever. And obviously, like, she was the only grandkid. So, like, when they would talk to, like, my mom's parents, they weren't, like, oh, like, grandma, grandpa. They were just, like, Sally, like, Dale, right?
Yeah.
Like, that's her name, right?
Yeah.
And then I guess my cousin was just, like, oh, like, Mammy Sally. And then that's kind of just, like, how it stuck.
And then what, where, and then Papa?
For... I think she came up with that one, too. Like, sometimes we call him Papa or Papa Dale. Like, we call him, like, whatever grandparent name.
And then the name.
And then, like, their first name. And, like, okay. They don't care. Like, that's in my phone, I'll show you. In my phone, it says Mammy Sally.
That's adorable. I think it's because a lot of people, like, will let the kid decide what they call.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so the first grandchild, they'll let decide. He's not lying, folks. There's
not even a space?
He's not.
One word.
Just Mammy Sally.
Mammy Sally.
One word.
Okay, but what were you saying?
I feel like it's because they let, like, the first grandchild determine, like, so whatever comes out of their mouth, like, if it's, like, Gaga or whatever, that's just what it is.
Aww.
Except
Grandma and P-Pop.
Oh, except for my grandma. I'm not allowed to call her grandma because she thinks that she is. I mean, it's just facts that she's too she was too young for grandma. Mm-hmm. Which I get, like, if you, like, you know, I get. And so I call her nanny, not grandma. Shout out nanny.
Do you have any other different names for people in your family?
Not like my grandparents, like, we called him Pop LA and Pop Holly, but, like, pretty standard, I feel like.
Do you have, like
Papa, and then first,
like,
or last?
Do you have, like, different prefixes for, like, aunts and uncles too?
No, I think it's just grandparents. And, like,
aunties this and do that?
No.
I either call him, like,
Aunt Gina. Shout out to Aunt Gina.
Call him, like, auntie or, like, aunt and then first name.
Yeah, I think that's pretty basic.
No. Or like my
a lot of people have meemaws.
Yeah, that's an odd one.
My uncle, my mom's brother, I just call him by his first name. I'm like, yo, what's up, Steve?
He's like, yo, Jake, what's up? What's up, Steve?
That's bold.
Because we have that.
I feel like Uncle Steve amongst the whites is somewhat common. A lot of people got Uncle Steve.
Yeah,
a lot of people got Uncle Steve's. Yeah. No, that's...
But did your mom get mad when you call her mother?
Oh, yeah. But she gets mad when I'm like, Wendy. She's like, do not call me by my first name.
Dude, my mom hates when I call her mother. She goes, I'm still young. Mothers are old. I was like, God damn. Okay. I was like, Mommy. I have her.
Mommy.
I'm on my phone. I have her saved as Mummy. M-U-M-M-Y.
That's
Mummy.
Really cute.
Mummy.
I saw a TikTok where...
Or sometimes when
that.
I call her, I'm just like, what's up, birth giver? How are you doing?
Oh, my God.
Birth giver. That's bold.
I saw a TikTok where it was like red flag number one is if he has his mom in his phone, and it said if he has mummy or mommy.
No. Wrong. Sorry, you guys are jealous that I have a great relationship with Christina.
That's facts. Trendy Wendy. I mean.
Love of my life. Queen. Fire in my heart. I would do anything for that woman.
I want to meet her.
Yeah. Wait, no. I think I did. Yeah.
You met
early
Christina.
On. Early
Don't
on.
F*** with Christina, bro.
I will never.
Hell hath no rage like Christina.
Should we start adding them to the shout-outs?
Shout out Christina. Shout out John. Shout out Josh. Shout out Mammy Sally. Shout out Papa Dale. Shout out Uncle Steve.
You have to send this to them now.
Yeah, I will.
Okay. Do you have any more? Any more 2+2?
Oh,
we went off the rails.
We went off the rails.
Just,
My 2+2=5. Now this one, I'm very confused about, and I would like somebody to bring up at the next board meeting, if you're listening, why they took the McDonald's snack wrap off the menu if all people love it. This does not make sense to me. It would make you a ton of money if you just left it on the menu like a normal person. Like, no, I am so passionate about this. Like, I will advocate for myself.
No, but
I loved that snack wrap. You know what it had on it? Ranch dressing. And let me just tell you, it was so good. Why would you take it off the menu? It's making you hella money.
You know the crazy thing is? They have all the ingredients. They just choose not to make them.
No, that's what I'm saying. 2+2=5. That shit does not add up.
You know they do that at a lot of fast food places, and I don't get it. Like a Taco Bell.
Or like seasonal shit?
Not even that. Like, Do you remember when back in the day when Wendy's had spiced chicken nuggets?
Oh,
and they
yeah.
were fire,
yeah.
They brought took it them back. Away. They brought it back now, but they were gone for like fucking 8 years.
No, like they do it, I think, to like maybe bring back the hype or something. But no, then people forget about it. Like, why would you not just, they would make way more money if they just left it on the menu.
Yeah.
That does not make sense to me. That grape Pop-Tarts, they did the same thing.
Oh, hell.
Grape.
They were grape.
Oh, hell no.
They were grape
delicious.
That's foul.
No, they had gross. They had white icing with pink and purple little sprinkle things on them that like blue looked like blueberry ones, but it had purple. Grape. Absolutely phenomenal.
When did they remove these?
Like when I was in third grade, and darn if I do not, I look every single time in the grocery store for these Pop-Tarts. And there's a whole population out there that loves grape Pop-Tarts. Why would you take these away? Why? Just like, let me know. Like, if somebody can write in the comments, like, let me know why. Because 2 + 2 = 5. That would make you so much money. You have all the ingredients. That's a fantastic point.
You know, my favorite sweet from any fast food restaurant is like
what?
A dessert item, like a sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, Subway chocolate chip cookies. And out of this world.
Subway cookies go crazy.
Out of this world.
The like the ones that are like reverse chocolate chip. They have the white chocolate chips and they're
I'm talking about regular chocolate chip cookies.
And they just have them in that little fucking like little case.
Oh
you
yeah.
Just look at them and you're like, yeah, I'll have a cookie.
That's some great marketing
right there.
And it's
like 10 times better than the sandwich you get because like their shit's kind of mid, honestly.
Yeah, it honestly is.
But that is true. And they do that. They did that with Taco Bell, like the potato. They took all their potato items off for a while, which is
really?
Like the spiced potato soft taco at Taco Bell is one of their best items.
Well, I have a hot take for you, Jad.
Okay. You don't like potatoes?
I don't. No, I love potatoes.
Okay, I was going to say.
My nickname is Carby Barbie. I love a carb. I love a carb.
How many nicknames do you have?
A zillion.
I love it. Okay. Oh,
my hot take. I don't like Taco Bell.
That's fair.
I'll say it. You're gonna give me that one, like
no. I know a lot of people who don't like it. I think that it's like you either had the people who fucking love Taco Bell or just they're just like it's not.
It's just not real food. It's just.
Oh, it's
but McDonald's. I love McDonald's. I will die on that hill. I took my undergraduate graduation photos at McDonald's.
Did you actually
look on my Instagram right now?
Wait. I want to know then this. Do you like? Have you had In-N-Out before?
No, I'm from North Carolina. I've never been to California, but I'm going over spring break. Yeah.
Are you gonna try In-N-Out?
Hell yeah.
Can you try it and let me know? Because Alina and I had an argument on her podcast because she loves In-N-Out. She's from California. And I had In-N-Out for the first time when Jacob drove me to Arizona.
Oh, I remember y'all talking about this.
And
Amazing Grace,
that's
baby.
That's what it is.
And I hated it. I was like, I'd rather have a Quarter Pounder than this In-N-Out burger.
I'll let you know. I mean, I love McDonald's.
Yeah.
I love McDonald's. Absolutely. I mean, I eat it like 4 times a week. I'm not going to lie to you. However, I'm a little sad now because I was recently diagnosed. I'm lactose intolerant now. It's a new development for me. It's horrible. It's absolutely horrible. And I loved a McFlurry.
Yeah, McFlurry.
And I'll still get it, and I'll just take my GasX Extreme.
GasX Extreme.
And and just apologize to Philip and just call it a night. Are you still looking for this photo?
Yeah.
I can find it way faster than you.
Sorry, I don't creep on your Instagram.
You don't believe. You don't
Wait,
believe.
I want to see this too.
No, it's back.
Can we put them up on the screen for people so they can see?
They can see my iconic graduation photos. Here we are.
Wow.
Like just, I mean, here. I mean, that's on my Instagram. Right there. Look
at
me.
You're doing a really bad job, Jacob.
Bro, I don't see it.
It's because I'm a micro influencer.
Go through all of them. I want to see these.
Oh, then these are.
Oh, okay.
These are just my other ones. Wow. Yeah, but the McDonald's ones, I got a lot more where that came from.
Did you get a professional to do your grad?
Gabrielle Strickland. Shout out Gabrielle Strickland. That's my cousin.
Your cousin?
And she actually is a professional photographer.
Wow. Because I was going to say, I don't know how you convince like a professional photographer to be like, hey, I want to go to McDonald's actually.
Oh, you pay anybody the right price. But that's true. Gabrielle has the vision. Shout out Gabrielle. You should look at her Instagram.
Those are really good.
No, she has great photos. She does a lot of editorial work and she does a lot of like really cool iconic photo shoots. I think you should really do one. You're really photogenic.
Do a photo shoot with her?
Yeah.
I prefer to be behind the camera. I was a freelance.
You're in front of it right now.
Freelance. Well, this is different. as in for photos. I was a freelance photographer in undergrad. I did just random photography work here and there.
I like that.
But I, if you look through my phone, I have no pictures of my. I don't like taking pictures of myself.
I do not take pictures.
I will take pictures every single time.
I have to have people take pictures of me and send them to me because I won't have it.
I took a picture of you today at Sky Zone with the that kid was your child. I'm sorry, in a different life.
I saw it. That was actually child. Shout out Xavion. He's the goat. He was wearing a Minecraft shirt. We started talking about Minecraft and like
they were laying in the corner. Like
Fortnite. Yeah, we were just chilling. I'll pop the pickup on the
dude. I accidentally like landed in front of him and like knocked him down.
Yeah,
like
we didn't even mention this. We went to Sky Zone today, played dodgeball with a bunch of six or seven med students just playing dodgeball and jousting with just a bunch of children.
No, the best part is when the woman came up to me and she goes, "Hey, how many kids do you have?" And I blinked at her. And I was like,
isn't that rude?
No, she literally came up to me and I was like, "What?" And I said, "None." And she goes, "Oh, are you just like here by yourself, like bouncing?" And I was like,
"Getting judged the entire time."
No, I could be babysitting these children. Like,
yeah, that kid, I like knocked that kid over and I like Xavion and I was like, I lift them up. I'm like, "Are you okay? Are you okay?" He goes, like, okay.
I'd say the max age, not counting us, was probably like 12.
Yeah.
And then it was just a bunch of like 24, 25.
But no, honestly, it was fine because we got to act like a kid again and just off. It was like so much an hour and a half.
Bro, the shout out Jeremiah too. This dude, he wanted a 1v1 on the jousting, on like the balance beam jousting. Oh. And I let him beat me the first time and he goes, You let me win. You let me win. I was like, "All right, bet. Next one," I just decked the shit out of him.
You literally almost cracked his head open.
Oh, I did. Okay.
Yes, you did. He almost hit the corner. I was scared.
And then he got up and he, good sport. He was like, respect. So we did it a third time and I let him win. Obviously, but I made it seem more like I was trying.
It was realistic.
And then my favorite moment was I was in like the foam pit and I was like, "Jeremiah, I can't get up. You're gonna have to help me up. I can't." He goes, "Dude, come, you could get up. Just get up." And I was like, "No, come on, just
he was not buying your shit whatsoever.
He finally grabbed my hand. I was like, "All right, bet." I let go and I just
I can't. It was a good time. It was a great time.
It was a great time.
Honestly, it's $14 a month for a pass. That's a great investment. It's
$14 for an hour and a half.
For
a whole
For a whole month.
And it's unlimited.
No, not unlimited. 60 minutes a day, every day for a month is $14. And I think we should invest in that and go with the homeschool PE class.
How often are we really going to go?
I would go for, like, to get my wiggles out. Like, I mean, sometimes I'm just like...
I'll tell you this. We're going to be sore tomorrow.
Oh, I'm already sore. Dude, when I walked out of there, my L5 S1 was on fire.
Really?
Yeah. I was hurting.
I was sad there wasn't a rock climbing wall. I thought there was supposed to be a rock climbing wall.
Yeah, it's a very bare-bones Sky Zone. They also didn't have a real foam pit to jump into.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. They had that tarp, but the ass part about the tarp is you can't go head first because you're going to crack you're going to break your spine and become paralyzed. Right?
Well, that's really morbid.
Well, because it doesn't.
No, give. I mean, that's facts. That's
but the,
facts.
In the foam pit, you can like pencil dive right in and it's great.
Yeah.
I don't know why they didn't have it. It was so sad. They didn't have the rock climb.
And when I was a cheerleader.
Oh, to jump in?
Not to flex or anything. National champion, but go Cats. Yeah, but at the bottom of the foam pit, they cleaned it out and there were snakes.
Oh my God.
So every time I think about a foam pit, I think about the snakes at the bottom.
Yeah.
Every time I think about a foam pit, I think about how grody it is.
Jacob said it best right when he left. He said, "COVID for sure started here."
Dude, that's facts.
And we were sweaty as fuck.
Dude, when I went home, I
showered immediately.
Obviously, I like warm showers, but like when people are like, "Oh, I like hot showers, like boiling," like that's not for me. Dude, I was a fucking lobster.
I was afraid I was going to get lice.
Took my loofah and I scrubbed and I was just like,
yeah,
I'm pretty starting over.
But it was a great time.
It was a great time. Dude, one time, so my 8th grade birthday party, I think I told y'all this, was at a trampoline park.
Mm-hmm.
And fun fact, if you lose anything in the foam pit, they will not let you get it. Like they won't clean it out or anything. And so my dad lost his debit card. He screamed and he was like, "Hey, can you like tell the kids to stop jumping in there? Like, can I like actually look for it?" And the worker was like, "No, dude, people paid for their money. Like, sorry, you can't." He was like, "Well, can I come after hours?" They were like, "No." So he screams and he goes, "I'll give any kid $100 in cash if you can buy my debit card right now. This little four-year-old little girl, she had two pigtails in. She was like, is this it? And my dad was like, here you go. Thank you.
What a G.
It was iconic. He's a G.
Is it in that waiver somewhere? I mean, I didn't read that
shit. I didn't waive.
No, it was like, check the boxes.
I was like, okay, check.
It was like, if you die, we're not responsible. I was like, oh.
Hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
If I die, bury me at Sky Zone.
You are kind of signing your life away when you sign that waiver.
Yeah.
But real quick, because we're already at an hour 20. Did you have any more 2+2s?
Dude, I'm scared now. I feel like those, my main ones. Oh, the other one I told you about earlier.
Which
one? Nobody believes me. Okay, well, I'm going to say, well, actually, I do have a lot, but that's for another day.
Okay.
But the one I'll end on.
Okay.
Is 2+2=5. Okay, I was trying to decide which one I needed to talk about, and I think that, honestly, I'm going to talk about time zones. They don't add up to me.
Time zones are stupid.
Absolutely. Oh, no. Like, when do you decide that? Like, we switch time zones. Like, us between here and El Paso. I don't even know if we're on the same time zone. Maybe. Yeah. We are. Okay. Well, oh, it's Dallas and El Paso.
Here in Phoenix. Here in Arizona.
Like, it doesn't make sense. I'm sorry.
Arizona borders. Like, an hour and a half, 2 hours.
No, like, I'm sorry. That just, like, simply does not make time to me.
Wait, we are now? Why?
Yeah, but like in March for daylight savings, because Arizona doesn't do that bullshit daylight savings. Yeah, shit.
Daylight savings, that 2+2=5. I'm sorry.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, time zones are stupid.
Dude, and you know what confused me so much was on my birthday, because this is the first time that I've been in a different time zone than a lot of the people that I know, because I grew up in Michigan and I spent my whole life there. So everyone, we were, you know, on Michigan time. It was like 10 p.m. and everyone's texting me happy birthday. And I'm like, it's 10 p.m. Like my brother calls me. He goes, happy birthday. I'm like, dude, it's 10 p.m. I'm so confused. And then I realize
somebody a happy birthday. Like, when?
Yeah. How does that even work? Does it? So since we live here now, technically my birthday's at midnight this time.
Yeah. Like, I'm sorry.
So they were actually 2 hours early and their happy birthdays didn't count, is what I'm hearing.
That's what I'm hearing too.
No, but it's stupid.
I'm sorry. That's like, it does not add up to me. It never will. Daylight savings does not add up to me. Why do we do it? What if we collectively just decided to stop doing
that? That's what Arizona did. And it's probably great.
Well, I know, but then there are the odd ones out. Like, we all just need to
So Arizona just said, like, fuck you to every other state and was like, we're just going to do our own thing.
Honestly, I respect it. It's very cowboy of them.
Can we like?
Yeah, Arizona's dumb. Or no, Arizona's just
so distracted.
No, Arizona,
try to tell people
to wait.
Dude, yeah. Are people at your house right now? We gotta go.
Anyways, okay. So Arizona is dumb because, one, they were like the one state that was like, no, we're not gonna do that. But on the other hand, they're so smart for that, because I did not have to put up with that change your clock, move your clock bullshit growing up.
Yeah, that was
like, gross. I remember the first time I had to do daylight savings when I was in here, I was like, do I just
wait? The first time you had to do daylight savings was like
In November. Like, that 3 months ago.
First daylight savings ever.
Yeah. So I was like, do I just move my clock now before I go to bed, and then I wake up and it'll be like the same time?
Except when it goes back, it's nice.
Yeah.
Because it'll be like 3 a.m. or no, it'll be like midnight, and then you're like, oh, I got to go to bed. And then you look again and it's 11. You're like, ah, I can stay up for another hour.
Dude, like.
But when it goes forward, that.
No.
Goes an hour. What is it? Fall back and spring forward or whatever?
I don't even know. They would just tell me to do
it. Dumb and dumber.
We gained an hour.
Dude, you honestly probably know more than me about it. They tell me to move my clock, I move my clock, and that's all that happened.
But it sucked because for the longest time, like, me and my parents were on different time zones when I was like here for school.
It's just an hour.
I know, but it still sucks because it's like, because we're an hour ahead, right? So if I'm like, call him when I get home, like, my dad's like, I'm at work, can I call you back? I'm like, oh yeah, sure. But now that we're on the same time, it's fine. Just makes me feel closer to home.
Aw, it's adorable.
Even though it's only 5.5 hours away.
Alright, I think we should wrap up.
We got derailed quite a bit.
We're gonna do our round of advice, a life advice we do at the end of every single podcast, starting with Jacob. Jacob, do you have any he's dealing with. Okay.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
He's hosting the party.
So let's tell him what's going on right now.
Yeah. So basically, we're about to finish the block. We're about to go hang out, like, meet up at my place and go out to some fine establishments.
Mm-hmm.
And I told people, yeah, I'll swing by like 8:45, 9 o'clock. It's currently 9:16. and people are like
doing this.
People are like, "Oh, I'm like at your door. Like, are you here?" And I'm like, "Oh, I had to run to the store. Like, I'll be back soon or whatever." So, we got derailed.
Yeah.
But anyways, because we're coming up on
hour 30,
hour and a half.
All right.
Anyways, so my life advice, for this week is. I f***ing hate it here. You know what? Going with the theme, my advice, if you're going to host a party, add on an hour for yourself.
Yes.
To do what you need to do.
That's good advice.
And if it's not, it's not just a party, it's in life. If you think it's going to take you an hour, if you tell people to come over at a certain time, you're going to be there at a certain time, please give yourself some extra time. This shit's stressful.
Yeah, I feel bad.
So that's okay. What I got.
Grace?
That's good. My life advice is don't save the outfit. If you want to wear the outfit, if you want to wear the sparkly shirt, you wear it, because clothes won't change the world, but the women who wear them will. Period.
Damn. Wow.
Shout out the Gatorbug Boutique. Love y'all, queens. That you can liar. Use code GRACE10 at the Gatorbug.
Shameless plug.
Shameless plug.
My life advice would be careful when you're reheating. Just when you're reheating old rice, because you never know when a little bacillus will be living in there, and I'll tell you that you will be throwing up more than you thought was in your stomach after that. So just be careful. If it was in their fridge for a little bit longer than a few days,
yeah,
it might be time to throw it out. And yeah. Honestly, this could be extrapolated to life, you know. Sometimes it's okay to just drop things and move on if it's not working out, you know?
Drop it like it's hot.
It's better to move forward, move on to bigger and better things, right? But if you really wanted to eat that rice, I would still eat it and incur the consequences. But if it didn't matter that much, just get rid of it. Was that your stomach?
Yeah.
That's his fried rice talking.
Right. Well,
anyways, Grace, it was an absolute ball having you on the podcast.
Thanks for having me, brothers.
I think this vlog was so good. We're going to need a part two.
I would love to come back for a part two.
Billy on.
Dude, yeah, and we can do our icks about each other. I want to say that shit on the pod. Love you, brother. Well, not brother. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Could be worse.
I didn't think you were that sad.
Could be worse, brother.
But anyway, we gotta run our shout outs real quick. Shout out Besma, that's my mom. Shout out Fadi, that's my dad. He's also a viewer now. Aww. Shout out Sparky's mom.
Trendy Wendy.
Shout out Wendy.
If you're watching this and you're not a parent,
you should be a parent now.
Send this to your parents, because for some reason, parents love us.
They do. Can't
don't know
cut
why.
It off.
Parents love us. So just send us to your parents, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Shout out Mammy Sally. Shout out Papa Dale.
Mammy Sally. Love you, queen.
Signing off. Peace.
Take it easy.